So, at the present moment, in our conditional state, we are separated. Not exactly separated, but we are forgotten. We have forgotten our relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, we have to connect it again. That is called yoga. Because we are now disconnected somehow or other, now we have to connect it again. So any yoga system means an endeavor to connect our relationship with the Supreme Lord. That is called yoga. So, someone is trying to make the connection, karma yoga, someone is trying by jnana yoga, someone is trying hatha yoga. But the real aim is bhakti yoga. Just like different steps. You are on the first step, and other is on the second step, and other is on the third step, and other is on the fourth step. But the ultimate goal is bhakti yoga. You cannot understand God or Krishna by any other yoga. It may be a step forward. But ultimately, you have to come to the bhakti yoga. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, bahunam janmanam ante, after many, many births, endeavor to execute the yoga system, bahunam janmanam ante, jnanavan, one who is actually practicing jnana yoga or mystic yoga, he comes to the bhakti yoga. Bhavanam janmanamante jnanvan manga prapadyate. Prapadyate. This is bhakti yoga. And still clearly explained. What is that prapatti? Vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlava. When one comes to this understanding that Vasudeva Krishna is everything, I surrender to Krishna. Krishna is canvassing personally. Krishna is so kind that sarva-dharmān paritajya māme kam saranam. That we will not take. Krishna is claiming too much. But that is the ultimate goal, that you have to surrender to Krishna. That is the highest perfection. So this conclusion, that let me surrender. Krishna is asking me, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the ultimate absolute truth, the holy name of the Lord, then you become devotee. This is the purpose of this Ajami Upakhyan. Ayam hi krita nidvesha. Nidvesha means atonement. If you commit some sin, then you should atone for it. Otherwise, you have to carry the reaction of your sinful life to the next life. Therefore, according to the Vedic system, there is prayaschitta. The prayaschitta, that is also a very heavy task. In this age, nobody can perform prayaschitta. And even one is able to perform prayaschitta, then there is possibility of again falling down, unless one is clear consciousness, and that Krishna consciousness. Unless one is Krishna conscious, there is every chance of falling down. So anyway, this ajamin is kritanidvesha. Vishnu Duta informed to the Jamaduta that you cannot touch him anymore. He is now pure. कीर्तन निर्वेश कीर्तन निर्वेश देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द जमदूत में से दैट हाउ ही हैज बिकम कीर्तन निर्वेश ही सो सिंफुल दैट देर इज नो लिमिट ऑफ हिज सिंफुल एक्टिविटीज एंड यू से दैट इट इज क्लियर इमीडिएटली दैटफॉर ही सेज जन्मकोटि अमहसामपि नॉट ओनली वन लाइफ सिंफुल एक्टिविटीज बट मेनी क्रोर्स ऑफ बर्थ सिंफुल एक्टिविटीज सो वी डू नॉट नो हाउ मेनी बर्थ्स वी हैड प्रीवियसली बट फ्रॉम दिस शास्त्र वी अंडरस्टैंड क्रोर्स many millions of times we had to take birth. That word is used, janma koti. Not one birth or two birth or second birth or third birth. So, unless we come to Krishna consciousness, this repetition of birth and death will continue. That word is said, janma kotiya. We are passing through many forms of different forms of life. We are creating one family that I belong to this family. But what about my other families? Because janma koti, in every family when I enter, there must be father and mother and family members. To which family I am especially concerned, that is our ignorance.